Today we are starting this video in a rather unusual fashion. We have a picture shot on the Infinix Note 10 Pro and Samsung Galaxy A32. I want you to quickly use the comment section below to tell me your favorite picture among the two, and make sure you like this video as well. The Infinix Note 10 Pro and Samsung Galaxy A32 both have a 64 megapixel main camera, and you just saw a little comparison right now. They come in at a similar price, and there are some differences and similarities that I'm going to talk about in this video. The Galaxy A32 comes in at 117,000, while the Infinix Note 10 Pro costs 120,000 naira. If you are interested in buying any of the phones in this video, they are available at Lambda and they sell at recommended retail prices. They offer free delivery to every state in Nigeria, and pay on delivery is also available. Make sure you check the link in the description below. So, the Infinix Note 10 Pro or the Samsung Galaxy A32, which should you buy? In this video, you will find out everything that is there to know about both phones, starting with the contents you get inside the box of both phones. The box of the Infinix Note 10 Pro is bigger than that of the Galaxy A32, and that is because we have more content inside. Opening the box, you will find the phones, a 33-watt fast charger inside the box of the Note 10 Pro and a 15-watt fast charger inside the box of the Galaxy A32. We have a USB Type-C cable inside the box of both phones. We have a TPU case, screen protector and earpiece inside the box of the Infinix Note 10 Pro. And Samsung doesn't give you a protective case despite knowing that the phone is as slippery as an eel. Talking about design, both phones are made of plastic and it's more durable than glass. We have glass at the front of both phones, and the Galaxy A32 has a Corning Gorilla Glass 5 protection. Infinix, however, does not specify the type of protection on the display of the Note 10 Pro. If you like bigger screens, then the Note 10 Pro comes in at 6.95 inches. However, the Samsung Galaxy A32 comes in at 6.4 inches. I find it more compact and easier to use with one hand. We have a center hole cutout on the Infinix Note 10 Pro, which is trendy. The cutout is a little bit big when compared to other phones with center hole cutout displays. The Galaxy A32 is rocking an Infinity V style display. An Infinity O cutout would have been better here, but that's what Samsung is giving us at this price point. We have an optical in-display fingerprint scanner on the Galaxy A32, and I find it slow. The Infinix Note 10 Pro uses a side-mounted fingerprint scanner and it's faster. We have a refreshing design on the rear of the Galaxy A32, and it's not the regular camera bumps we are used to seeing. Each camera has its own cutout. The Note 10 Pro has a bump that houses all the cameras, including the flashlight. More on the cameras later in this video. They both charge through USB Type-C. We have a headphone jack on both phones, and they both have down-firing speakers, but the Infinix Note 10 Pro has a second speaker at the top. The SIM slot is placed on the same location on both phones. As far as design goes, I prefer the looks of the Galaxy A32, though it's very slippery and using it without a case is a difficult task. The Note 10 Pro is not as slippery as the A32, and it has some sort of matte finish at the back. Talking about the display, the Galaxy A32 uses a Super AMOLED display, while the Infinix Note 10 Pro uses an IPS LCD display. Now, both phones have 90Hz refresh rate, and the high refresh rate makes using both displays enjoyable and faster. The Super AMOLED display on the A32 is very bright, and it can get up to 800 nits outdoors when set to auto brightness. The IPS LCD on the Infinix Note 10 Pro is decent, but not as bright as what we have on the Galaxy A32. They both have a 1080p resolution display, and streaming content on both phones is great. You can get better colors on the A32, however. Screen to body ratio is similar here, even though we have an Infinity V cutout on the Samsung and a centered punch hole cutout on the Infinix Note 10 Pro. Samsung have some of the best display in the industry, and after using a number of phones with an AMOLED display in 2021, the A32 has to be the best so far. I've used the Redmi Note 10, which is one of the cheapest phones in 2021 with an AMOLED, and the Redmi Note 10 Pro Max, but they are not as close as what we have on the Galaxy A32. I have links to both videos in the description below. The Infinix Note 10 Pro has a decent display, and the cutout isn't noticeable when streaming content. In this aspect, the Galaxy A32 has a better display because it's very bright outdoors. The Note 10 Pro is very bright, but not as bright and good looking as the Galaxy A32. Now, the model of the Galaxy A32 that I have comes with 6GB RAM and 128GB of storage, while the Infinix Note 10 Pro has 8GB RAM and 128GB of storage. They are both powered by MediaTek chipset, with the Note 10 Pro utilizing the powerful Helio G95, while the Galaxy A32 is using the Helio G80 chipset. In this aspect, the Infinix Note 10 Pro is clearly ahead. It's faster than what we have on the Galaxy A32. The 8S2 is also fast, and when using the phone, there are no lags. I played COD Mobile on both phones and they handled the game perfectly fine. No lags or frame drops, but if you're a gamer, I'll advise you to lean towards the Infinix Note 10 Pro more. We have the Mali G52 as the GPU on the Galaxy 8S2 and the Mali G76 on the Infinix Note 10 Pro as the GPU. Performance clearly belongs to the Infinix Note 10 Pro. It launches apps and games a little bit faster than the Galaxy 8S2. This aspect clearly belongs to Samsung. Both user interfaces are different from each other, even though they are Android phones. They both run on Android 11 with each phone having its own custom skin. We have the One UI 3.1 on the Galaxy 8S2 and the XOS 7.6 on the Infinix Note 10 Pro. The One UI has better animation and colors than the XOS. Both phones come with pre-installed apps, but you will find more bloat on the Infinix Note 10 Pro. They both feature dark mode, but it's much more friendly on the Galaxy 8S2. You get ad pop-ups on both phones, but one on the XOS is much more aggressive. The notification and home screen menu on the Galaxy 8S2 looks better. I feel Infinix should continue to work on their user interface. Over the years, they have refined it and it's getting better and better. Samsung has guaranteed 3 years of software updates on the Galaxy 8S2, while we are not sure if the Infinix Note 10 Pro will get beyond the Android 11 operating system that it came with. They both have a 64-megapixel main camera sensor, an 8-megapixel ultra-wide lens, a 5-megapixel macro lens on the Galaxy 8S2, a 2-megapixel macro on the Infinix Note 10 Pro. Finally, a 2-megapixel monochrome lens on the Infinix Note 10 Pro and a 5-megapixel depth sensor on the Samsung Galaxy 8S2. Here are some pictures. Up front, we have a 20-megapixel camera on the Galaxy 8S2 and a 16-megapixel selfie shooter on the Galaxy 8S2. The Infinix Note 10 Pro is capable of shooting 4K at 30fps and 1080p at 30 frames per second. The Galaxy 8S2 is only capped at 1080p 30 frames per second. Both phones come with a 5000mAh battery, and even though they have a high refresh rate, they last a whole day on a single charge. I used the Vivo V21, and with high refresh rate on, the battery drained significantly faster. They both have fast charging ability, but the Infinix Note 10 Pro have a 33W fast charger that charges the phone from 0 to 100 in under 2 hours. The Galaxy 8S2, on the other hand, takes at least 2 hours to charge from 0 to 100. Using the 15W fast charger inside the box. This aspect should have been a tie, but the faster charging speed of the Note 10 Pro will save you some time. Both the Samsung Galaxy 8S2 and the Infinix Note 10 Pro are incredible phones with huge differences and similarities. If you want a better display and software, then the Galaxy 8S2 is the way to go. The Infinix Note 10 Pro is faster and bigger. Camera on both phones is decent. I won't pick one over the other. As far as mid-range phones go, they are some of the best released this year. The decision to buy any of the devices here lies on what you want outside the camera. If you made it this far, then a sub will be appreciated, and I'll be with you in the next video.